good morning. Today we are going to start with the discussion of the question answers from the poem Legend of Northland. Right? So we have enough discussion about the main theme which the poet wants to deliver through this poem. And the poet has clearly mentioned about the human qualities which are always appreciated in the house of God also. It means that the poet wants that human beings should develop a softened as well as listening attitude, feeling behavior towards the other fellow beings. They should be helpful, they should be kind, they should be generous towards others. Otherwise, they have to suffer or they have to feel or they have to face the consequences too. Okay, so coming up to first question, and those students who want to give the answers, they can raise up their hands. First is, which country or countries do you think the Northland refers to? This we have discussed earlier also, that which country it refers to. It refers to the countries which are situated in the extreme, you can say Arctic region, where most of the time it is covered with snow and people used to wear furry clothes in order to keep themselves warm. It can be in any region in that Northland where the days are long and nights are short. Days are short and nights are long. Okay. So next is, let me unmute you, dear. Yes. Second question is, what did Saint Peter ask the old lady for? And what was the lady's reaction? So what did Saint Peter ask the old lady for?
After a long day of preaching and moving around the country, Saint Peter asked the old lady for some cake. The little lady's reaction was that she refused. She did not refuse, but she started baking smaller and smaller cakes for she was reluctant to give any to the saint. She was greedy.
Okay. Yes. So what did Saint Peter ask the lady for? As Saint Peter was tired of preaching, as he moved from one place to another, so he came across a small cottage where the woman was baking the cakes. So Saint Peter asked for a piece of cake so that he can be relieved of being fainted due to hunger. And what was the lady's reaction? The lady did not speak a word or did not deny to give a piece of cake, but she thought that the cakes that she is baking, they are too large to be given to anyone, but they're too smaller for her to be eaten. Okay, so what happened? So ultimately she baked almost a thin wafer that evoked Saint Peter's anger. So how did he punish her?
Angered by the woman's selfishness, Saint Peter lost his patience and reacted by punishing her with curse. He pronounced that she would no longer enjoy the comforts and blessings of human life. Ample food, secure shelter, and the warmth of fire will no longer be available to her. She would become a woodpecker and would have to drill the hardwood all day for food.
Okay, so how did he punish her? As the Saint Peter got angered, because the lady was not ready to part with her piece of cake. She did not want her piece of cake to be given. And ultimately, this evoked Saint Peter's anger. And he caused her to be changed into a woodpecker. And she told her that she did not deserve a human form. And for that, what happened? She was once passed through a chimney and was turned into a woodpecker. What she was turned to? She was turned to a woodpecker. Okay, so the next question is, how does the woodpecker get her food? Yes, how does the woodpecker get her food?
The woodpecker gets her food by drilling boring very small holes in the trees to feed on insects and other forms of food.
Yes, or you can say the woodpecker gets her food by boring into the barks of the trees and by moving from one place to another. Okay, right? So the next question is, Do you think that the old lady would have been an ungenerous if she had known who Saint Peter really was, and what would she have done then? Yes, Panika, you can answer. Yes,
yes, ma'am.
Speak the answer.
Yes, ma'am. No, the lady would not have been so ungenerous. She had known that who the Saint Peter really was. Instead, she would have welcomed him in her house happily and given him several large cakes to please him and to get his blessings.
Yes. So ultimately, the thing is that she would not have been so ungenerous as she behaved with Saint Peter had she known the reality of Saint Peter. She would have been more generous in order to mark her impression and to avoid any type of curse and mishappening befalling her. So this is the reason why she behaved in an ungenerous manner, as she did not know the reality of Saint Peter. So, is this a true story, and which part in the poem do you feel is the most important? First of all, is this a true story? No, this is not a true story.
No, ma'am.
No.
Because even the poet has said that, I don't believe that it is true story. Okay, he has also said that, I don't believe that it is true story. And moreover, he has also mentioned that this is a folk tale which is being passed from one piece, from one generation to another. And ultimately, what happens that whenever you can say such kind of stories, they are passed from one generation to another, then there may be different kinds of, you can say, changes that have been made while they are being transferred from one generation to the next generation. Okay? And which of the part is most important? Otherwise, you can write down any part of the poem is important, right? But here, when the woman was changed into woodpecker and she has learned the lesson that part of the poem was important, as this explains the complete crux of the poem, the complete gist of the poem, or the complete essence of the poem, in which it is explained that what happened because of her bad deeds and because of her selfish deeds, and ultimately selfish people, they have to suffer. So clear this one? Next. What is a legend, and why is the poem called a legend? Why is this a legend? This is a legend because, yes, explain the piece. Can
A legend is a mythological story which is passed on orally from one generation to the other. There is no evidence to prove its accuracy, but it still remains in circulation for its instructive value. This poem is called a legend because it is the story of a Saint Peter and the old woman from ancient times. Its historical origin can't be proved, but it teaches the lesson of love, kindness, and charity.
Yes, who will explain what is the legend again?
Ma'am,
can I?
Yes,
ma'am, may I?
A legend is an old popular story which is believed by many, but one can't prove whether it is true or not. It usually contains a message or a moral and is narrated to children.
Yes, it is passed on from one generation to another and is a part of folk culture. Okay, why this poem is called a legend? This poem is called a legend because it is a part of folk culture also. Moreover, all the generations are very well known to the story which was related to that old woman. And almost, it is also mentioned that almost all the school going boys, they have watched that woodpecker boring and boring, learning the lesson that they should not be selfish and they should help other human beings. Okay. Write the story of a legend of Northland in about 10 sentences. This you will write on your own. Okay. So now, coming up to some extra questions that I'm going to write on the board. Okay, now let us discuss those extra questions, please. So the first question is, why did Saint Peter curse the woman?
Why did Saint Peter force the women and what did he turn into? So who will explain the answer? Yes, what did she turn into? Explain the answer.
Saint Peter cursed the old woman for her ungenerosity and greedy nature. The saint cursed her that she would turn into a woodpecker. She did not deserve to live in human form, and now she would have to build her nest like a woodpecker and work extremely hard for food.
Ultimately, she was changed into a woodpecker. Why she was changed into a woodpecker? Because of the reason, according to Saint Peter, as she was not ready to part with her piece of cake. And moreover, Saint Peter thought that this kind of inhuman woman did not deserve a human form. This is the reason why she was changed into woodpecker. Okay, so what is the theme of this story, of this point? What is the theme of the poem? Who will explain the poem? Theme of the poem, which I have explained a number of times. Yes?
The theme of the poem is to indulge generous and selfless nature in the readers.
This poem
it promotes moral values and.
So mainly the theme of the poem is to be helpful towards other humans. As God has made man, or man is the finest creation of God. So it is expected from human beings that they should not turn a deaf ear towards the requirements and towards the feelings of others. So ultimately, what is there? So the theme of the poem, the poet ultimately wants to deliver us the lesson that we as human beings should be helpful towards others. We should always listen to the problems of others. We should never turn a deaf ear. We should not show an unfeeling behavior towards others. And this is what the poet wants to deliver through this poem. Okay? What do you learn about the women in the poem? What do you learn about the women in the poem? In the poem, yes. What do you learn about the woman in the poem? What kind of woman she was?
We learned that the woman was so ungenerous and was very greedy.
Ungenerous. She was
greedy. Extreme.
She had a large store of cakes but refuses to give away even that is as small as a
selfish greedy.
She was also having unfeeling behavior towards the feelings of others. This is the reason why she was not ready to part with her piece of cake. When Saint Peter came to her house and asked for a piece of cake, she was not ready to give her cake to him, as she thought that his cake seemed too big to be eaten by anybody, but they are too small to be eaten on her own. Moreover, she was not understanding that Saint Peter has traveled throughout the day from one place to another and was preaching, and he is tired and he needs some food. So she is also, of course, having unfeeling behavior. She is selfish also, as she was just thinking only of her own welfare. She was not at all thinking about Saint Peter also. Moreover, she is greedy in nature. It is just because of her greedy nature that she was not ready to give any piece of cake to Saint Peter, right? Okay. Next. And what do you learn about Saint Peter? What do you learn about Saint Peter? So what you have learned about Saint Peter from the poem?
Saint Peter was a wise saint. He had traveled and preached a lot, so he was tired and hungry. Hmm. He had arrived at the woman's door for some food. But still the lady made him wait for the cake for a long time and didn't give him a cake. And so she turned the lady into a woodpecker.
So Saint Peter, who was a saintly figure, and moreover, he is always teaching and moving from one place to another in order to teach people. Okay, so he is and he is giving sermons. He is related to God. But ultimately, he is also a man who got angered when the lady did not give him a piece of cake, okay? And he also wanted to teach the woman a lesson that if she is showing any unfeeling behavior, and such kind of human beings, they never deserve to be a human being. So this is the reason why he has changed her into a woodpecker, so that she should understand what are the problems of the other creatures. Ultimately, he gets angry also. Right? So, what is the message of the poem? If I talk about message, means greed is a quality which even God does not like, and one should not be greedy in order to avoid any kind of, you can say, and to avoid any kind of punishment. Right? So, next question is, why does the poet say that the hours of the day are few? Why does the poet say that the hours of the day are few? Let me write on the board also for your reference. Some of the students may find it a problem. Next is, why does the poet say the hours of the day are few? Why he says that the hours of the day are few? Yes.
Ma'am, may I?
The poet says.
The poet was describing the geographical condition of the area, that in the Northland it was winters, and due to this, the days were few, hours of the days were few, and
the nights are longer than the days were shorter.
Why does the poet, I'm not getting the clear answer.
The legend of Northland is a poem based in the north, northern region of the earth, where sun rays are slanting, which makes winters longer, which ultimately leads to hours of the day, making hours of the day fewer as compared to the hours of night.
Yes, because this is a story, this is a legend which has its origin in the Northland, okay, which is a region of extreme, you can say, cold weather, where most of the time it is covered with snow. So at such places, according to the weather, the days are shorter and the nights are longer, okay? So this is the reason. Why was Saint Peter tired and hungry? Why he was tired and hungry?
Saint Peter was tired and hungry as he had traveled from very far. He met with the woman who was making cakes. Hunger, tiredness, and the reaction of the woman towards him made him lost his temper. He was so hungry that he needed some food very urgently.
That's why he was tired and hungry, as he was an apostle of Jesus. Okay, like that of Jesus. He's preaching throughout the day, giving sermons to people, and for that purpose, he has to go from one place to another without taking care of himself and Jesus because of this reason. As he traveled throughout the day, giving out his teachings in the name of God, And ultimately, this is the reason when he reached the old woman's cottage, he was tired and hungry. Okay? What happened to the cakes the woman baked? What happened to the cakes the woman baked? What happened to the cakes the woman baked? What happened to the cakes?
After baking, she stored them on the shelf.
So the woman who was baking the cakes in her cottage, when Saint Peter came and he asked for a piece of cake, the woman was not ready to part with the piece of cake, as she thought that the cake that she had made, it was too large to be given to somebody, but it was too small to be eaten. Then ultimately she took an even smaller dough than the previous one and baked another one. But when it was baked, she thought that it was almost of the same size like that of the previous one, right? So, again, finally, she ended up in baking up a wafer only by taking only a scrap of dough, and ultimately this at the anger of Saint Peter, and he cursed the women, right? Yes. Who was the lady and how did she provoke Saint Peter? Who was the lady? And how did she provoke Saint Peter? Yes. Who was the lady and how did she provoke Saint Peter? Yes. Who was the lady?
The lady was an ordinary woman sitting outside her house baking cakes. Mm-hmm. She provoked Saint Peter by her ungenerous and greedy nature when he asked her for a piece of cake, but she constantly makes another thinking that the one she has baked is very large for to give away, but very small to for herself to eat. This angered the Saint Peter, and she was ultimately turned into a woodpecker.
Yes, ultimately the lady was a woman who was baking cakes in her cottage, and Saint Peter, who had come there as he was tired of teaching throughout the day. So ultimately he was feeling too tired and he asked for a piece of cake, but the lady was not ready to give him a piece of cake, as she thought that his cakes, they are too bigger to be given away, but they are too smaller for her to be eaten. So finally she ended up in taking just a scrap of dough and ultimately baking only a wafer. This at the anger of Saint Peter, this provoked Saint Peter. And ultimately what happened, that he cursed the lady, okay? That he cursed the lady and changed her into woodpecker, okay? So mainly we have studied that in this poem, mainly enchantment is used. So what is enchantment? When there is not any use of any punctuation mark, like comma or full stop, at the end of the line, and the item of the one line is rolled on to the next line. Okay. So one sentence, it is, you can say, rolled on to the next sentence carrying the same idea. This is called as enjambment. So in this poem, throughout enjambment is seen along with alliteration and 2 to 3 examples of simile. So if I talk about what are the examples of simile here, for example, it was as black as coal, thin as paper. Okay. So these are the examples of simile used here. Okay. And look like beer cups. Okay, so these are the examples of various poetic devices used in the poem. And with that, the discussion of the poem is complete. And I hope that everything is clear to you. If you have any doubt now, you can raise up your hands so that I can take your doubts.